a thoroughfare. It's the part a little on New York that runs in two Times Square. Our crazy quilt that Wall Street Jack built. If you've got a little time to spare, I'd like to take you there. Come and meet those dancing feet on the avenue I'm taking you to, 42nd Street. Hear the beat of dancing feet. It's a song I love, the melody of 42nd Street.
Petting in the dark, bad girl. What you doing, honey?
Oh, I feel so funny.
Heading in the park with you. Heading in the park. Tweet, tweet, tweet. Heading in the dark. Tweet, tweet, tweet. Then a little. Let up a little. Then you get a little kiss. Heading on the slide. You beat it out of the door. Act a little shy. Tweet, tweet, tweet. Struggle just a little. Then hug a little. Cuddle up and whisper. What you doing, honey?
Oh, I feel so funny.
Petting in the park with you.
Boys!
Shanghai Lil.
I miss you very much a long time. I think that you no love me still.
I've been looking high, and I've been looking low, looking for you, Shanghai Lil.
I think you go with other sweethearts, and very many tears I spill.
He's been looking high, and he's been looking low, looking for you, Shanghai Lil.
I got new lover.
You little devil, you're just a butterfly.
I like new lover.
You're still on the level, you can't kid this guy.
I pray to Buddha in the Josh house, and Buddha, he bring back my bill.
He's been looking high, and he's been looking low, looking for your Shanghai Lil.
Measured for costume.
Oh, gee, thanks.
All right, girls, take it easy.
Hello, Mr. Ames.
Hello. What's going on downstairs? Dollar Day?
Country store night. We're giving away a set of fishes with each gown.
When Carla was here, you couldn't even give the gowns away.
No, but seriously, don't you think a fashion show will stimulate business?
Sure, sure. Whose idea was it?
Mine, teacher.
Yours?
Uh-huh.
Well, it just isn't possible.
What?
A girl as pretty as you are with your ability?
I suppose it's the boss's privilege to kid his employees.
Oh, but I'm not kidding. I'm very serious. I think about you a lot.
If you'll pardon me, Mr. Ames, that all sounds a little familiar. The next thing you'll say, you've been dreaming about me.
No.
Although my dreams were always pleasant,
You were never present in my land of dreams. And then you came along to wake me, came along to make me realize the dreams were cold and blue after seeing you. Oh, I don't have to dream again. Never have to dream again. Now I know how empty all my dreams will be when you're so lovely in reality. You're a breath of spring with all its sweet perfume. I hear violins when you walk in the room. So I don't want to dream again, my dear. Not as long as you are here. Dreams are only dreams, but you are really true. So if I only get a glimpse of you every now and then, I don't have to dream again.
They're ready to start, Miss Riley.
Oh, thank you, Warren. Could I interest you in a fashion show?
Oh, certainly. You could interest me in most anything.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next showing of our latest creations is about to begin. Step this way, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
suppose that every woman knows the magic and the mystery of clothes. Oftentimes an evening gown worn at a dance may be the inspiration for romance. It takes a pretty frock to show your pretty curves, to give your figure all the beauty it deserves. What would you look like before an altar rail, without a trousseau or without a bridal veil? And every lady's wardrobe always should include a different gown for every different mood. Oh, how soon the honeymoon can fade away without the lure of lovely lingerie. I suppose that every woman knows the magic and the mystery of love. Now the fashion show is over, here we are at the very door of our boudoir. But alas, I fear I have to say farewell, for I've a lot of idle gowns to sell. As a bridegroom, you've done very well. I turn you over now to Annabelle. I like a rhythm and a melody to sing, to swing to. I like to dance because I like someone to cling to and sing to. Culture doesn't mean a thing if you haven't got that swing. You're asking me what kind of man I like, I'll answer, a dancer. If you want to win my heart, don't be too intelligent or smart. Don't go in for literature and art, but you gotta know how to dance. You don't have to have degrees from a lot of universities. All you need is rhythm in your knees, and you gotta know how to dance. Now don't the trees blow up a breeze to give the little flowers and plants a chance to dance? And don't the tones of saxophones make your head spin, inveigle you in romance? Let's dance. If you have the right technique, I don't care what language you may speak, I don't care how much you make a week, but you gotta know how to dance.
My introduction, please. The introduction. Yes, thank you.
Roll on, thou deep and dark blue ocean, roll. A thought.
Jane is gonna get you a swell ball. Ladies, I've a plan to get you a man, but you've got to know your foot from your elbow. You can always rate as a dinner date, really give the fellas a treat. They'll be sending flowers and candy if you're handy with your feet. You can be the champ as a local vamp, just the type they're dying to meet. and you'll soon be drinking their brandy if you're handy with your feet. Take my tip and tap, tap, that is the way to start. Take my tap and tiptoe into your baby's heart. When your big romance takes you out to dance, cuddle up and tell me, sweet, you'll be close as Amos and Andy, and won't that be dandy? Just remember to be handy with your feet. You know that game called Handies that everyone was playing? You use your hands to illustrate a picture or a saying. For instance, here's a handy. Perhaps it's rather balmy. I heard it from an Englishman. It's moon over my army.
That game went out with hairnets, as far as we're concerned.
I know, but now I'll teach you all another game I learned. Just relax and give yourselves a treat while I do a handy with my feet.
And a hearty welcome to the College Club. For our first number, we proudly present the pride of Lambert Tech, America's heartthrob, Betty Blake.
The song in my heart is the music I dance to. The song in my heart is the tune I romance to. I love it to start, cause it gives me a chance to say hi. Tap happy. my ship keeps in time with my decker. I follow it through and the tempo is slicker. A thinking of you makes the beat of it quicker. And boy, tap happy. The song that's running round in my brain is lyrically sound. Down to the ground, the throng is taking up the refrain. It's all about you. Listen to the song in my heart. It's the music I dance to. The song in my heart. It's the tune I romance to. I love that you start, cause it gives me a chance to say, I'm tap happy.
The song in my heart is the music I dance to. The song in my heart is the tune I romance to. I love it to start, cause it gives me a chance to say, I'm tap happy.
A pair of dancing feet, the greatest feminine tap dancer of them all. The little Irish girl who hoofed her way to stardom from the sidewalks of New York, Ruby Keeler. Ziegfeld star and then movie star and now teacher. But today it's all in the family, Ruby's dancing family. 11-year-old Ruby Keeler, a niece. Margaret Newman, 9, another niece. Ruby's 6-year-old daughter, Teresa. And Chrissy, her 5-year-old daughter. Joe Vira, 7, a nephew, another niece, 3-year-old Francis Newman. A famous dancing family. 10 years ago, Ruby Keeler retired from the screen to become Mrs. John Lowe and the mother of 4 children. But now it's a comeback, both as a star and as a teacher, at the White and Manning Ruby Keeler Dance Studio in San Fernando Valley, California. And as a hobby, backyard instruction for the whole Keeler family. And a close eye on 6 pairs of tiny dancing feet. But Joe Vira got his signals crossed. Ruby signaled for routine number 2. Joe got confused. This footwork can be complicated. But with a teacher like the famous Ruby, things get straightened out. And even the kids reflect the precision she made famous on the stage and on the screen. Here's Ruby's brother, Bill Keeler, who reminds Ruby that one of her students played hooky. It's Ruby's son, 4-year-old Johnny. Bill explains that he found Johnny out playing cowboy and Indians. Johnny likes to dance, yes, but gosh, Ma, those Indians might have scalped the whole family. Ruby understands, and Johnny figures he can let the Indians wait a few minutes while he shows his mother and his Uncle Bill that he can hoof right along with them. And there's a picture for you, like mother, like uncle, like son, a dancing family, starring the one and only Ruby Keeler.
No, No, Nanette, first opened in 1925, was a resounding success, and history has been repeating itself for the last 16 months. a Broadway star of the 20s, Ruby Keeler, left the Ziegfeld musicals behind when she went off to Hollywood. But she's come dancing back with a casual disregard for the passage of time. And perhaps that's the secret. When we're in a theater, we are, all of us, audience and performer alike, always young.
We've seen Footlight Parade, and when we saw Miss Ruby Keeler with us on Monday, when we showed 42nd Street, I said to her, you cannot leave without our getting the chance to ask you about By a Waterfall and Shanghai Lil and a few other things. So, she's back. Welcome back.
Oh, thank you, Tom. Happy to be here.
I must tell you, it's when you think of Busby Berkeley, you think of, well, the genius. Yeah. But the hard work is a part of it, too.
Well, plus the fact that he thought you could do anything, you know. I mean, you never said no, like the waterfall number. He said, well, it's going to be very simple, Ruby. I said, well, you know what, I can't dive. He said, oh, well, it'll be all right. He said, get in the water, and now here it's filled with girls, you know, all the girls, and they got in the water, and he said, what we're going to do and you'll be able to do it, or you'll have time to practice on a certain beat. We're going to do, you're going to do porpoise dives, and then at the last one, you look down, the camera's down below, and there's a window there, that's the camera, then you smile. I said, Buzz, I can't do that. He said, of course you can. Try it.
Let's get you out of the water and into the arms of Jimmy Cagney.
Oh, Jimmy.
That must have been a delight.
Oh, that was a delight. We had a great time doing that, and I can remember when I heard that we were going to do it, how tickled I was. And when they had the fight, they had a fight where he comes in. I always got such a kick out of it because this sailor is looking for his love, his Shanghai Lil, and finally here's this little nothing pops up out of a barrel.
Shanghai Lil.
Looking for your Shanghai Lil.
Tomorrow night, we are going to give you the night off. Tomorrow night is the Gold Diggers of 1935, and we will be back. Hopefully, you will be back, too. And thank you very much for being with us tonight. Good night.
From the 50s.